Hey friends, welcome back to What Remains of Edith Finch. Last time we discovered little artist Milton. We didn't really find out what happened to him, but we got to look at a lot of his artisticness, which was phenomenal. I don't think there's anything else to interact with here. There is flipping paint everywhere. I love the mustache. Thing. Apparently I am not standing on this correctly. There we go.
Mom spent months searching for my brother. Then she sealed the doors.
I'm sorry, he went missing. He went missing and they never found him.
Whatever Milton had found in the house, Mom didn't want it getting out.
So now we can go back. And maybe we'll learn about her parents.
Mom definitely blamed Edie, but I think Lewis blamed himself. After he graduated, he just spent more and more time in his room. Until Mom got him a job at the cannery. Everyone always told me to stay out of Lewis's room. Except Lewis.
He was the stoner kid. Alright, this will be fun. 1988 to 2020. I like these though. Seriously, everybody needs those chairs in their way. How do I do this? My room is a boat.
Lewis's room smelled very, very familiar.
I'm sure.
That part of him lived on.
No, I just looked at it. I didn't even move towards it. I just looked at it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, game. I'm so sorry. There's a bottle opener. He's a gamer.
Lewis and I spent a lot of time playing games together, but he was surprisingly bad at them. He died a lot.
It's like me. I am very bad at games. I get lost all the time.
Dear Mrs. Finch, as Lewis's psychiatrist, I can understand your desire for an explanation. As I see it, the trouble began in January, shortly after we convinced your son to seek treatment for substance abuse. Newly sober, I believe Lewis first noticed the monotony of his daily life. He kept working at the cannery.
Oh, God.
But he withdrew part of himself. In our sessions, I saw the same behavior. His mind began to... Wander. I asked him to describe it. He said he started small.
This is hard.
Imagining a labyrinth.
This is not the easiest thing. I'm playing one game. Playing another.
He'd feel his way about. Then something moved. Bats. And toads. And things that have not names. He knew it was all in his head. But he took it very seriously. I had hoped he'd find himself.
It's okay, Lewis. One thing at a time. One thing at a time.
But he found something more.
Fish! I found fish. Oh, nowhere in three dimensions.
I worried about him then. Daydreaming at the cannery. I spoke with his boss. But he said Lewis had become a model employee. Methodical,
because,
tireless,
yes,
focused.
That's why. Because he doesn't have...
Like a whole new Lewis.
Capacity.
So I let him go on.
Where am I?
I even encouraged him. It seemed very promising at first.
Is this healthy?
He told me he'd made a new friend.
There's a doggy! I have a companion!
On the edge of a city he named Lewis Topia.
Go.
He built the city up slowly, brick by brick.
I have adoring.
Then he made musicians. Songs for them to play. He talked about starting a band.
I'm a little overwhelmed.
And he was always humming something.
There's a lot to concentrate on right now.
Every day his imagination grew stronger. He no longer spoke at the cannery. His chopping was as reliable as ever. Then one day it struck me that all the cheering crowds, even the stones under his feet, were all in his imagination. So he could do whatever he wished. He held an election for mayor. And he won.
I would have been so concerned if
they begged him to stay, but his mind was already wandering. It became a game for him. He'd conquer a city, then immediately push on. New Lewisville. St. Louis.
That's the
obvious. He started drifting away from our reality. Minneapolis. Until one day he forgot to go home from the cannery.
That one's green. I just forgot.
Even as his mother pleaded with him, part of Lewis kept sailing off. In Lewisburg, he heard rumors of
a beautiful prince. What if I just stopped?
The prince was on his own quest for sinister serpents. He followed the sound of his silver harp. His chase led him to a golden palace east of the sun and west of the moon.
Oh, I love that. That's my favorite.
Even then, his logic remained sound. He knew the world was all in his imagination. But he was so proud of having created it. In his own eyes, he'd become something greater than a king. Someone who'd never known success in the real world, I think it was overwhelming. And then it struck him that the real Lewis was not the one chopping salmon, but the one climbing the steps of a golden palace. My imagination is as real as my body, he told me. It was hard to argue with him. Began to forget the world we know.
What am I doing? Lewis.
I think it pained him to remember Lewis, the cannery worker.
Pardon my sit.
He began to despise the man with a royal contempt. I still thought I could save him.
Hi, Lewis.
Even after he said he was being crowned king over all the lands of wonder.
I don't know how well this is gonna go.
The palace would be packed with his companions. There's only one thing left to do. Mrs. Finch, your son was a kind man who will be missed by all of us who knew him.
Okay. All right. Okay, that was unsettling. Sorry for the
My brother was really cool.
Commentary.
I wish you could have met him.
You're using like your full capability to focus on playing two games at the same time, and it's a little harder playing games first of all, when you start adding commentary to it, and playing the two games and then trying to commentate over top of it just kind of overwhelmed. But thank you so much for joining me in this video. I will see you next time. Goodbye.